In everyone's life, there's one special time that's never forgotten.
You're very attentive.
I like math.
I mean to me.
Innocent love brings happiness to a young boy, awakening to feelings for an older girl.
I'm very worried about Harry. He's just a kid.
Innocent love, what every parent fears, can bring pain.
I want to transfer away from here.
A story of love that will touch your heart.
Molly, I don't want you to go.
Doug McKeon of On Golden Pond and Melissa Sue Anderson and Innocent Love next Tuesday.
This is CBS.
Good evening. A Bethlehem tax protest shakes Lackawanna City Hall tonight.
And the Buffalo Common Council raises its voice over firehouse closings. News 4 Update is next.
I'll have a Miracle Whip sandwich.
Gee, it's kind of late, mister.
Please?
Well, okay.
Can I have another? Make it a double.
It's getting pretty dark.
Oh, come on.
To make any sandwich irresistible, just add the zesty taste of Miracle Whip salad dressing, the bread spread from Kraft.
Oh, maybe your mother can turn on the porch light.
I gotta do my homework, mister.
Where you going with the Miracle Whip? Don't put it away, please.
There's some things you don't see when you walk into the warmth of a Chi-Chi's restaurant, like the impeccable array of ingredients we use. The freshness. The artful preparation of each and every dish, plus style and a little showmanship. We take so much care because what you don't see, you still taste. Chi-Chi's, Mexican food for American tastes. Chi-Chi's.
Now, take advantage of Elaine Power's incredible low price. Only $6 a month for our complete six-month proven program of weight loss. But hurry, this offer ends Saturday. Call now. Don't miss out.
From Western New York's first news station, here is News 4 Update.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Bob Koop.
And I'm Carol Jason. Bethlehem Steel provides the economic heartbeat for the city of Lackawanna. But as Emil Jablonski reports tonight, a possible tax hike of $800,000 is shaking the plant's foundation.
Bethlehem Steel pays 66% of Lackawanna's total property taxes. And tonight they're complaining because next year they stand to take on an even bigger role.
The message to everyone at tonight's Lackawanna budget hearing was, we'd like to raise your property taxes. Well, the message from Bethlehem Steel, where 5,500 are working and 3,000 are laid off, was, cut that budget, reduce that tax hike, or else.
I don't like to predict additional layoffs or try to make a prediction on the economy, but certainly this tax situation is a very serious detriment to the ability of this plant to be more than at best more than a marginal operation.
But tonight, Lackawanna's council president said he's worried about Bethlehem, but not running scared. Problems like pollution haven't always made for a rosy relationship.
I think that we lost a lot of tax base on account of Bethlehem Steel with real estate in the first ward of the city.
The council has just a few days to decide on the tax hike, with the haunting warning from Bethlehem hanging over their heads.
The end is that if there's no steel plant, there's not going to be any tax base for the city of Lackawanna.
Emil Jablonski, News 4 Update.
Well, whenever a municipal government's tax base is so dominated by one industry, so dependent on one industry, it can cause some real problems for that government. Our Live at 11 guest tonight is Lackawanna City Council President Thomas Radich. Mr. Radich, Bethlehem says they can't afford the higher taxes, so what kind of accommodation can the Bethlehem people and the City Council come to?
Well, I don't think that they can't afford the taxes. I think that their big problem is that they are contesting, you know, their assessed valuation. And they did agree on their assessed valuation in 1972 when they got the machinery exemption bill, which excluded them from $13.5 million, which the city of Lackawanna absorbed. And we're not ready, you know, as of yet, to give up any services in the city to Bethlehem Steel or on account of Bethlehem Steel's court proposal.
Well, that's going to make you a little bit nervous when you think of that implicit threat that they make, that they may pull up stakes. What happens then when you lose over 60% of your tax base?
Well, if we lose 60% of the tax base, I'm sure we're going to lose our identity as a city, and we'll probably go into bankruptcy.